the skin. Run, 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 but you sure can't hide. Well, nobody's interested in learning but the teacher. Segregation, determination, demonstration, integration.
Good morning and welcome to Detroit Wants to Know. This week we're coming to you from downtown Detroit. We're coming to you from the end point of the 2017 Labor Day Parade. You know, people take labor for granted. As I said a couple weeks ago, we would not have the 5-day work week. We would not have sick days. We would not have maternity leave had it not been for the unions. Today, we celebrate Labor Day in downtown Detroit. My first guest this morning is Dave Berry with the UAW, UAW Ford, and you do veterans outreach.
Yes, we do. We have a veterans department that we represent and support our veterans, mm-hmm. Not only UAW veterans, but veterans across the country as well.
Mm-hmm. How do you help the veterans? I mean, we've heard all this stuff about the VA hospital providing not enough treatment. We've heard all this stuff about post-traumatic stress among veterans. We've heard all this stuff about veterans not being able to find work. What does the UAW do?
Sure, Steve. We support a lot of different initiatives across the country, ranging from mobility issues, mm-hmm. To, as you said, PTSD. Mm-hmm. We have a wide range of partnerships that Vice President Settles has directed us as far as supporting. And he believes that it's our responsibility to give back to our country's heroes. So in many different ways, one way that we do support our disabled veterans is through our ramp program. Not only do we build ramps here locally, but across the country for disabled veterans. And they meet a wide range of age groups, all the way from the Korean War, Vietnam War, to the Middle East War, where veterans who have been seriously injured, wounded, who need ramps going into their homes, mm-hmm. things that we take for granted. Mm-hmm. Our community service teams will virtually build the ramps for mm-hmm. the families, and that's one way of mobility that we help with our veterans. Mm-hmm. Another one that we're proud to partner with is Wounded Warrior Family Support, who is under the leadership of Colonel Folsom. And what he does is he buys only UAW American-made vehicles. And what he does is has the engineering modified to these vehicles where disabled veterans can drive. Mm-hmm. A lot of things that we take for granted on a daily basis, whether it's we take our kids to school, whether we go to the store, these vehicles are modified and engineered from to where a handicapped wheelchair-bound veteran can drive themselves. And we're very proud to partnership with them, and very proud as far as our UAW Ford vehicles have been used. Mm-hmm. We used vehicles as far as our 150, our Shelby Mustang, which is made out of flat rock, and of course the 150 out of Dearborn. But we also, this year, we also used our F-250. So what we do is we partner with them, do different types of fundraising events, mm-hmm. and at that point they're able to provide a veteran the mobility that, you know, many wouldn't have.
I want you to know I keep buying a ticket to get that Shelby 350 and I never win.
Well, keep buying.
I never win.
I'm with you too.
But as long as it goes to a good cause.
Absolutely, absolutely. And in another area, I know you spoke of PTSD, uh-huh. Organization that we partner with is Active Heroes, mm-hmm. and their main mission is to eliminate veteran suicide. Mm-hmm. Along with that, they have a 150-acre resort, uh-huh. Which is out of Louisville, Kentucky, mm-hmm. And our teams down there, our community service teams, have built cabins down there. And also, they built a welcome center just recently, a 5,500 square foot welcome center. So we go far beyond just making donations. Our members are out there hammering the nails, putting these buildings up. And these transition resorts are very important in terms of when a soldier comes back from active duty in a war environment. This gives them the opportunity to transition back into civilian life. It also, you know, they can also have their families with them. It gets them a time of transition and going from whether it be a soldier or a sailor to being mom, dad, a husband, wife again. Also, they have resources for mental health, if there's any mental health issues, like you said, PTSD, which is very prevalent amongst our soldiers returning. So we do quite a bit as far as just not only doing the fundraising aspect of it, but also going in and doing the dirty work as far as hammering, sawing, doing all kinds of work.
That's interesting. And it's really interesting. I didn't know you did so much. If you're a veteran that has no idea about this, what number do they call?
They could call here at the MPC Center. My number is 313-392-7248, and we'd be more than glad to help them out, to assist them in any ways possible.
All right. Dave Berry, thank you for joining us.
Thank you. It's a pleasure.
Right. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back from the 2017 Labor Day Parade.
When you're having a heart attack, this is how it feels to your heart. And if it happens at night or on the weekend, there's only one hospital team standing by on site to save you. Cardio Team One, only at the DMC.
Mike's Fresh Market, Detroit's largest independent supermarket with the best prices, quality, and service. Enjoy our vast selection of fresh fruits and vegetables. Wide aisles lead you to our own in-house bakery and deli. Beef, pork, chicken, seafood, and much more. You can rest assured you will feed your family the freshest food in town. Whatever you need, you can find it here at Mike's Fresh Market. Mike's Fresh Market, with two locations, Gratiot and 7 Mile and Livernois and 7 Mile. Better food, better prices. That's Mike's promise.
Every year, DTE Energy helps its business customers save about $40 million on their energy bills. We perform over 1,800 free on-site business energy consultations and provide hundreds of money-saving incentives. Why? Because we're committed to helping Michigan's businesses and its people thrive. DTE Energy. Know your own power.
Always there when I need it. You could just call him. All I had to do was find ways to heal. And the legal side, Mrs. Johnson said, you don't worry about that. I have that taken care of for you.
When you pick him, you're picking a family member, because that's exactly what he treats you like, a family member.
It's personal with him. He was right there. It's like he's been in my life all my life.
My name is Lakia Costner.
I'm Dan Roster.
I'm Craig Rose. Ben Johnson fought for me, and he would definitely fight for you.
We are a part of a public-private partnership to place more than 40 kiosks throughout Wayne County to allow you to pay your essential bills and delinquent taxes in one safe, convenient location.
DTE Energy introduced this kiosk program to allow Metro Detroiters greater freedom to pay your energy and other bills when and how you desire, by cash, personal check, or credit card.
At the Detroit Water Department, we are pleased to join our friends so you can now pay your water bill on the DivDat kiosk network.
The kiosks are located in our respective downtown offices, as well as Rite Aid stores and community centers across the county.
As the president of the DivDat Kiosk Network, our mission is to stamp out convenience fees and help you.
Make sure to take advantage of the no-fee kiosks to stay current on your tax, energy, and water bills. Stop by today to learn more about how to enter into a payment plan in the newly extended interest rate reduction program.
Please visit us at DTE Energy,
the Wayne County Treasurer's Office,
or DWSD. We're here to help.
Groundbreaking. Life-saving. History-making. The new DMC Heart Hospital, summer 2014. The beat goes on.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're coming to you from the 2017 Labor Day Parade in lovely downtown Detroit. My guest this segment is Angelique Peterson Mayberry. You may know her by her non-paying job as a member of the Detroit School Board, but today we're going to talk about what she actually does for a living, which is amazing, and how it affects all of us. You're the Director of Community Outreach?
Yes.
For the UAW Ford?
Yes, sir.
Tell me about that.
So it's pretty awesome because UAW Ford is in the community so much, each and every day. You know, even today you figure Labor Day, and so people said, oh my gosh, UAW Ford is doing Meals on Wheels program, but we do stuff each and every day. Laborers are who we are, and in the community is where we are each and every day.
Tell me about this Meals on Wheels program.
So this is our third year that we've annually supported and been the main sponsor for the community event over at Meals on Wheels. 3,500 meals that were prepared for homebound seniors, and we had nearly 100 volunteers that came out through our organization. So in addition to building fabulous cars and trucks, we put that food on the assembly line and we packed some meals today.
Well, at least you know how to build things on an assembly
line. Absolutely.
2 weeks ago, we talked with Vice President, UAW Ford Vice President Jimmy Settles. We were at a ball field, the Ford ball field over...
On Canfield.
Mm-hmm. That you guys just built. And he talked about the stuff generally across the city. What other type of community outreach do you do?
How much time do we have?
3.5 minutes.
Okay, 3.5 minutes. But we do so much. I mean, you mentioned that ball field. There's one on the east side and the west side. $2.4 million each one of those fields. Just to have something in the neighborhood that young people can see and know that they deserve. We're in a ton of schools with Detroit Public Schools where we had a summer camp over the summer. We had a chess camp. We had a boys theater camp. We've provided sponsorship to mentoring programs. The list goes on and on about what we've been able to do. So in addition to serving our members, our UAW members, we've been able to serve the community as well.
Okay. So how does a community group approach you guys for help?
So that is huge because people, what we hope, Steve, is that people would, other businesses would step up to the plate as well. We want it to become infectious because there's only so much that we can do, but everybody can do something. So if everybody just bites off a little piece, we'll go ahead and take care of all of it. The need is huge, it's great. But usually what they do, just go to our website, uawfordcommunity.org, and they can see all the things we're doing in the community as well as let us know when they need some assistance.
Talking about the need being huge, we visited the Tyndall Recreation Center. And to see that transform from a shuttered rec center to what it is today is amazing. And that was through you guys' community outreach.
Absolutely.
Beyond the ball fields, beyond the Tyndall, beyond the Meals and Wheels, what else do you guys do?
I think what it is what we want people to know is that we're more than just factory workers. Uh-huh. You know, we are coaches. We are in the churches. We are in the schools. We are in the community. So don't look at us just as factory workers. We're out in the community, and we're doing things a lot of times that don't get the airplay, but it's okay. It's the intrinsic reward that we get. Providing for the community is what we do.
Providing for the community is what you do.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see that it will have an impact down the road in Detroit?
I hope
so. And in Kansas City and all the other places that you guys are.
Right.
Because you're not just here.
We're not just here.
I mean, Dave Barry's building ramps all across the country.
That's right.
There's community outreach going all across the country.
All across the country. So we're in 18 states. In each one of those locations, we have a community outreach program. Uh-huh. So every time we travel to one of those locations, we're able to magnify what those locations are already doing. So yeah, wherever we are, we're in the community.
All right. We've got to go. I know I could go a whole half hour with you alone. You'd be amazing.
Thank you.
But I want a promise from you.
Thank you. Yes. What's
with
the promise?
With your non-paying job, why don't you come back and have a little
Absolutely.
Talk with me?
I accept that challenge.
It will be a
it
challenge.
It will be fun.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back.
If you or a loved one needs help, call the Detroit Wayne Mental Health Authority at 1-800-241-4949. The Detroit Wayne Mental Health Authority is your provider for services when you need a hand. We provide services for your whole family in substance abuse, autism services, and parent support. We are there to help with people suffering from depression, anxiety, and those with developmental disabilities. We can assist you with a variety of your mental health care needs. Housing placement for the homeless, job placement, and prescription coverage. As the largest mental health care organization in the state, it is our job to care for you from the neck up. We are the source for all your mental health needs. We are there for you and your entire family. Call us at 1-800-241-4949 or visit our website at dwmha.com.
Always there when I need it. You could just call him. All I had to do was find ways to heal. And the legal side, Mrs. Johnson said, you don't worry about that. I have that taken care of for you.
When you pick him, you're picking a family member, because that's exactly what he treats you like, a family member.
It's personal, but yeah, he was right there. It's like he's been in my life all my life.
My name is Lakia Costner.
I'm Dan Roster.
I'm Craig Rose. Ben Johnson fought for me, and he will definitely fight for you.
Every year, DTE Energy helps its business customers save about $40 million on their energy bills. We perform over 1,800 free on-site business energy consultations and provide hundreds of money-saving incentives. Why? Because we're committed to helping Michigan's businesses and its people thrive. DTE Energy. Know your own power.
We got our dream home at a dream price.
It's buildingdetroit.org.
This was the house that was meant to be.
We actually have a house. I mean, this is our house.
Register to bid, attend an open house, buildingdetroit.org. Welcome home.
Now, see more homes for sale than ever at buildingdetroit.org, including Own It Now homes, online at prices from $1,000. Just go to the Own It Now page at buildingdetroit.org.
Hello, I'm Dr. Shauna Diggs, and welcome to Cosmetic Dermatology.
As Michigan's leader in comprehensive skin health and rejuvenation, board-certified dermatologist Dr. Shauna Ryder Diggs and the entire Cosmetic Dermatology team take a caring, customized approach to skin care. The Cosmetic Derm team effectively treats skin diseases and autoimmune diseases, such as lupus. State-of-the-art laser technology is utilized in hair removal, tattoo removal, and skin peels. To learn more, visit our website, Cosmetic Dermatology, where science and beauty meet.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're coming to you from the 2017 Labor Day Parade. My guest this segment is Bob Tizio, and he's in charge of apprenticeships at UAW Ford. How does that work? How does somebody get on at the plant?
Oh, so with our apprenticeship program at UAW Ford, it's an internal program.
Uh-huh.
So what we have is our production workers have the opportunity to take what we call our industrial readiness certificate program.
Uh-huh.
So they can take these three college courses using their education benefits, and if they pass all three of these courses, mm-hmm. and they submit their transcripts, they'll get put on a wait list within uh-huh. their plant.
Okay.
And then as we put apprentices on, they get ranked by seniority within that year, and as we put apprentices on, they get a chance to get on the program based on, they get to choose three different trades. So based on how many apprentices we put on in any given year, based on their seniority and where they fall on that list, they'll be selected to come on the apprenticeship program.
So this builds from within of UAW Ford. So you're taking somebody from one level to a higher level.
Yes. So one of the things that UAW Ford that we're very big on is trying to upskill our workers and give them more opportunities. You know, during collective bargaining in 2015 under our Vice President Jimmy Settles, we really adapted the mentality as we wanted to build skilled tradespersons in our plant versus buying, which means hiring them off the street. We wanted to create opportunities for our members to get those skills that they needed, whether it be an electrician, plumber, pipe fitter, millwright, to name a few.
Wow. Wait. Plumber, pipe fitter, millwrights? Not just building cars.
No, absolutely not.
Help me out here.
You know, within our plants, we have production workers that are building cars and trucks.
Right.
But we also have skilled tradespersons that make sure that these lines keep running. And they need the skill sets to be trained in controls, logics, hydraulics, machine repair, things to be able to keep the line running.
When people think about the UAW, they think about building a car. They don't think about everything else that goes along with building a car. The operations of a plant, for example. That's very, very interesting. Now, these skills that you get them apprenticeships for, let's say they're a plumber, a pipe fitter, are they transportable? Let's say they go into a different field, let's say they go to building a new arena or whatever like that, or is it just localized to Ford?
No, our apprenticeship program is registered by the Department of Labor.
Mm-hmm.
So they'll go through, it's a task-based apprenticeship, meaning they have to complete a certain number of tasks based on their trade. But once they get that journeyman's card, they also get a certificate from the Department of Labor saying they've graduated with these skills to have this apprenticeship. So our program, you can go, if you were to decide to leave the company, you could get a job on the outside.
That's amazing. How many people are involved in this apprenticeship, this internal apprenticeship program?
Currently, we have about 950 apprentices.
Mm-hmm.
That's countrywide, and then I think a total probably about 8,200 journey persons.
Wow, that's amazing. And are you seeing the benefits of this with your employees? Are you seeing them reach higher levels?
Oh,
is it working?
Yeah, absolutely, it's working. When people have an opportunity to learn new skills and be more marketable, right, they really seize the challenge. Uh-huh. You know, we're watching our workforce really excited about our program, really taking the opportunity and excelling in it. So it's absolutely working.
All right. Bob Tizio, that's amazing. For your workers that are at the plant, is it hard to apply to the apprenticeship program?
Oh, absolutely not. All they need to do is sign up for the three classes. Right, we actually have a partnership with all the surrounding community colleges around our plants, mm-hmm. and then we also have an online partner. So if somebody works maybe a different schedule, an alternative work schedule, or have children that need attention so they can't go to school late at night, mm-hmm. so they'll be able to take them online. So once you sign up for those three classes, you can pass those classes, get on the program. We also have a rep at every plant, so mm-hmm. if somebody's having some issues, they can go see the joint apprenticeship rep, or they can also go see their education rep, not to mention from the national level, we have representation they can reach out to.
Okay. Bob Tizio, I want to thank you very much.
Thank you.
That's amazing stuff. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back from the 2017 Labor Day Parade.
When you're having a heart attack, this is how it feels to your heart. And if it happens at night or on the weekend, there's only one hospital team standing by on site to save you. Cardio Team 1, only at the DMC.
Always there when I need it. You can just call him. All I had to do was find ways to heal. And the legal side, Mrs. Johnson said, you don't worry about that. I have that taken care of for you.
When you pick him, you're picking a family member, because that's exactly what he treats you like, a family member.
It's personal with him. He was right there. It's like he's been in my life all my life.
My name is Lakia Costner.
I'm Dan Rollister.
I'm Craig Rose. Ben Johnson fought for me, and he will definitely fight for you.
Every year, DTE Energy helps its business customers save about $40 million on their energy bills. We perform over 1,800 free on-site business energy consultations and provide hundreds of money-saving incentives. Why? Because we're committed to helping Michigan's businesses and its people thrive. DTE Energy. Know your own power.
Mike's Fresh Market, Detroit's largest independent supermarket with the best prices, quality, and service. Enjoy our vast selection of fresh fruits and vegetables. Wide aisles lead you to our own in-house bakery and deli. Beef, pork, chicken, seafood, and much more. You can rest assured you will feed your family the freshest food in town. Whatever you need, you can find it here at Mike's Fresh Market. Mike's Fresh Market with two locations, Gratiot and 7 Mile and Livernois and 7 Mile. Better food, better prices. That's Mike's promise.
No other restaurant in Detroit is getting more attention for their award-winning food and service than the Detroit Seafood Market. And not to be missed is their spectacular Sunday brunch. Omelets made to order, roast beef carvings, fried catfish, and wonderful homemade desserts. Just $30 for all you can eat and two complimentary champagne mimosas. There's also a bistro-style brunch served on Saturdays for $15. The Detroit Seafood Market, located in Paradise Valley.
Groundbreaking, life-saving, history-making. The new DMC Heart Hospital, summer 2014. The beat goes on.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're coming to you from the 2017 Labor Day Parade. My guest this segment is Daryl Nolan, Executive
Administrative Assistant.
Executive Administrative Assistant, whatever that is. That means you're the guy that knows everything. All right. What is the importance of this parade? We've watched all different sorts of unions come down and everything.
The importance of it is working men and women coming together for a common cause, making up the middle class in this country. It's on display today, and I would also add, it's every day. When we show up in the workplace, representing our core values, being a part of organized labor, having a seat at the table.
Mm-hmm. Is labor dead? It seemed pretty alive with all the different organizations. I mean, you had everything from UAW workers to the sheet metal workers that looked like they were remnants of the ZZ Top band. I was like, where'd these guys come from?
Right, that's a very good question. No,
I mean, it seems like a huge diaspora. I mean, just a crazy thing.
Labor's not dead. I mean, as you said, I mean, Vice President Suttles and I walked up and I saw, you know, folks from diverse backgrounds representing their labor organization. It did my heart well. I mean, it was kind of emotional. Yeah, we're going through some tough times as organized labor, but coming out today, seeing men and women with their kids, grandkids, even saw them bring their pets out, that let me know we still have hope. Yeah. Absolutely.
It was an amazing scene, all the different colored t-shirts representing the different unions. So what is the future of UAW Ford? What can we expect? We know some cars are being moved offshore. We know that new cars are coming, the new Ranger, the new Bronco, and all that stuff. What's the future for you guys?
I believe the future for UAW Ford is bright. As we know, automakers are shifting to autonomous vehicles, electric vehicles. Vice President Suttles put together a team, Product Intelligence, working with Ford Motor Company, working upstream. And we're actually in talks now because that's going to come to pass. We're hoping 2020, 2021. But we're actually having conversations today to understand what that future workforce looks like. And we're spending time actually with our members at UAW Ford, you know, giving them all indicators that, you know, if everything stays well, the market, the economy, we're expecting great things at UAW Ford.
What about expansion of the UAW? Is that going to happen? Are we going to see that?
You know what, Steve? I mean, we're hopeful for that. Organizing is the backbone. It's what we're about in terms of organizing. I believe, obviously, you know, what took place in the South, you know, we got some regrouping to do. Uh-huh. You know, we need to understand what took place, and we obviously need to do some different things to get different results. Mm-hmm. So that's my hope.
Okay. For the young person coming in, now in Michigan, you have a choice whether to join a union or not join a union. Real quick, tell us why they should go ahead and join.
Recognize the history of the UAW. Understand where it all began. Understand that, you know, the rich folks in this country didn't just give you the benefits that you have today. Men and women fought and didn't even have a blueprint. So when you understand where you've been, clearly you will say, you know what? I need to remain part of this organization, the UAW. Absolutely.
All right. I want to thank you for joining us today.
Thank you, Steve. Thank you.
All right.
Thank
Ladies you. And gentlemen, the unions have been the backbone of Detroit and American society. When you have a chance, talk to a union member. When you have a chance, think about that paid sick leave. Think about that 5-day work week. Think about that maternity leave. Think about all those things that was brought to you by the unions, and specifically the UAW. Ladies and gentlemen, have a great week. We'll see you next week on Detroit Wants to Know.